Good morning.
Good morning. Together at this time.
Well, I would like to thank as well the English community and English football who shown great solidarity. Of course, it was a shock, a huge shock for our country and our football as well. And I think football world has responded the way you want it to respond, in a big union and a big togetherness.
It must have been a tough time, particularly for Laurent.
How did it affect you personally on Friday night?
I was not far from the event, and I think everybody was in Paris on Friday night was under shock, but the whole city was shocked. I think France is, like England, a tolerant and generous country, and to discover how much your own citizen hate you and hate the country is of course a huge shock for everybody. You wonder what's going on there. Why does this country get this kind of treatment? And I believe at the moment nobody in France has found an answer or a real explanation for what's going on and why, because what was targeted is the way of life, basically. Football, going out, listening to music. And so it's more way of life that is targeted than any individual community.
Did you fear for your own safety
when you were about to fly there? You know, I was more under shock than fearful, because you could be scared what's going on, because it was four different places who were attacked in the center of Paris, so you don't feel secure anywhere. And I was late in my appointment and was late to go to the stadium, so I decided to watch a game inside the hotel where I was. And in the end, in the hotel we were quite secure, but no, the streets were of course empty, completely empty. Hector Bellone is available again, and I believe that Ramsey should not be, Chamberlain should not be available. And of course, we have some longer term injuries. Walcott is 1 or 2 weeks away. And Rosicky, Welbeck, and Wilshere, of course, for later. I watched them against Man United, and they looked a very well organized team who is absolutely, as always, with Tony Pulis, full committed, you know. And so on top of that, they are in a difficult situation, a little bit in the Premier League. So you expect what you get now in the Premier League from everywhere is a committed, physical, fast game, and a game where we cannot afford to make any mistake.
I've heard you say a couple of times.
Do you agree with him?
Of course. I believe when you watch a football player, you don't know, you don't want to know what is his sexuality. What you want to see is a football player, no matter how he is in his private life, I think, of course. But you want to respect everybody.
Do you think the landscape of people's reactions, though, has changed?
How difficult it was to focus on the football?
Yeah, and I think he's a good example, because he had a fantastic game against Germany. And you could see that on Tuesday night he was not himself. And it affected him, I think, deeply. And I didn't recognize the player I saw on Friday night, on Tuesday night.
Do you think he'll be in the right state of mind to play on Saturday?
I will talk with him, and it's a big game for us. And I have not talked to him yet, but I will talk to him to see if he's completely recovered and focused. Look, I'm open to talk to the FA, of course. I just mean, you've seen that the doping problem suddenly turned up on track and field as well. We have a problem in cyclism and think that we in football are just immune because we are football players is absolutely wrong. What I want is deeper tests, better tests, because what we test is on the is superficial. And what you want is to make sure that, and as well, when people are caught, that they are punished. You cannot say that, and that the clubs are punished as well, you know. And we have to tackle these problems and not to close our eyes, because it's a little bit, not reasonable to think that just because we are football, we have no problems with it.
What kind of tests